Welcome back to StarrSoaps channel. How are you today? I'm doing good. Today I'm going to be making my Black Rasberry and Vanilla Star Soap. That's right, this one's so popular. So come with me and I'll show you how to make it again. Squee! Now, I know remakes for some viewers can be a little bit tedious, but I think you'll find that none of my remakes ever come out exactly the same, even though I try my darndest, and this soap is probably going to be the same. So if you were watching my last Black Raspberry and Vanilla soap making video, you would see that I changed the design up, and I really loved how it came out. So this time around, I tried to copy that exact same design plan, hoping to get an exact same looking soap, and I didn't. But that's cool. It smells amazing. It has a nice exfoliant because it has the added pulp and berry crushed up goodness inside, and it has a beautiful top. I'm really proud of how the top of this one's coming out, which you will see, spoiler alert. So first things first, I mix my lye and my oils together, and then while everything's super runny, I add a little bit to my fruit pulp and give it a really good mix. Then I'm going to go ahead and separate the rest of my batter into the colours before I come back and add more of it into the pulpy section. Now I really think that by adding produce, I help to anchor the fragrance. It's happened before for me with different fragrances, including orange ones when I added orange zest, and a chocolatey banana one when I added a banana powder. I'm not entirely sure about the science behind that, but I really do find that it helps to make that scent stick better and last longer. So let me know below if you're a soap maker and you've also had a similar experience, or a completely different one. I always love to learn and to hear about what you guys are up to as well, and we inspire each other. So I'm just going to go ahead and mix the colours with the spatulas, not with the stick blender, and then add the rest of the soap batter into the jug. Well, not the rest of it, sorry, but top it up and then give that a really good stick blend, so that I can make sure that fruity pulpy goodness is really well incorporated. And then I'll be able to pour it in the mould. Thank you. So I've poured it all in the mold and now it's time to do a hanger swirl. And I think that the main thing that's different between this batch and the last one is just how runny those colours are. They sort of haven't acted the same way as they did last time. So it'll be interesting to see with the final cut how it actually looks. Will it all be mixed together? Will there be fruit pulp at the bottom with colour at the top? I don't know, we'll have to cut them and find out. But first, I'm going to play. I know that I'm going to be covering these with toppers, but I cannot help myself. The artist in me wants to play and swirl. But as you can see, because it is so runny, the swirls are not really working out either. It's very wispy, and usually that's a good thing. Usually I want the soap to be super runny, but in this case, I needed to pay attention and I needed to make it just that little bit thicker. So for the very top, because I still want to play, I've taken some soap dye that somebody gave me and I've dribbled it all over the top. I added a bit more olive oil in it because it had tried to dry out on me. And I'm just going along the top and I'm just dotting it with this beautiful pink soap dye. And then I can come back and swirl that. Now, unfortunately, my camera died when I was trying to do the piping, and I'm very, very sorry you missed that part, because I know you guys love to watch me piping as much as I love piping. But here you can see the final result. I've gone for a single dollop with a berry on top, and I love this look. Simple is true. It looks so good. And with a little bit of the leftovers, I made these little soap meringues. And aren't they cute? I absolutely love these. I can give these away with a large order, or I can keep them for myself because they smell and look amazing. And I made a bunch more dollops for future batches. So it's sat overnight, and now it's time for us to cut the soap. And I'm kind of excited to see how the insides turned out. I absolutely love those toppers. I'm definitely going to do it like that again in the future because it looks so much like real cream with a real raspberry on the top. And it's in the name, right? Black Raspberry and Vanilla Cream. One thing with this batch is I went ahead and used the full recommended usage rate. So I do have discoloration, and in my final soap bars around the detailing, around the swirls here that you can see, went quite yellow. So what you can see now looks like a sort of a white line that turned to a very yellow line, which doesn't look yucky or anything. It's just changed the whole appearance again. And as you can see, those swirls are not as defined as they were in that last batch. They're still pretty cool though. I'm not sure what I can see. It's almost like ink blots. Please leave me comments below and tell me what you see in the swirls. I absolutely love reading it. It makes me have a little peek inside your minds. Well, I'm actually really happy with this. I love the bright pink in there. The purple is lost, but you can see the black and the pink and the fruity bits, and it smells so good. And here are the final soaps after I've beveled them, and they're up in the curing rack. So every single soap, I went around the edge with a vegetable peeler and beveled it just to make it look a little bit flasher. And I think I almost got a butterfly swirl there. That's pretty cool. I absolutely really love making this soap, and I'm going to keep making it. Pumpkin chai and black raspberry vanilla have become my signature soaps. But I'm also hoping that I can introduce a cherry soap, just because I love it, and I should probably get a cherry mold or start hand molding little cherries or something, because these toppers really help to set my soap aside from others, I feel. And I don't want to do big high piped tops on all my soaps, but I like to do piped ones on some of them. So, you know, conundrums. I think peppermint, for example, will never have a piped top on it. And man soap will never have a piped top on it, obviously. But black raspberry vanilla just needs a little bit of zhuzhing. So I hope you enjoyed watching me make these soaps. And if you did, feel free to hit that subscribe button and become a member of the Starr Soaps family. And this week, I'd like to highlight Jennifer Dymart Olson and her gorgeous sushi soaps that she made and shared in our group, Starr Soaps Family, over on Facebook. I love this girl. She came up with the idea for us to all send end slices of our soap to each other in Christmas cards. I, unfortunately, could not get any end slices that were thick enough, so it didn't work out for me. But she sent me one, and it's gorgeous! Well, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, hang around and see more. And come and join our group on Facebook, because we'd love to see your creations. Feel the soapy love. Bye.